Strip down to my skin and my bones. I love huskies, but I feel like a wolf. In a pack, but I feel all alone. I'm scatterbrained, man. Better off with a clone. And say hi, so Palmer will rain.
And here's what I have to say. Oh no, I'm not done with the stories. I have more to say. Me and Mama, I talk a lot. I intend with much strength to feel strong too. I intend to feel fortified. I intend to feel empowered. I intend to feel whole. I intend to. Every time I walk into my own place, I have to be scared that someone is gonna harsh me now. That someone is gonna hinder me now. Every day I go through hardship. Why? Because the people who hurt us are the ass-lickers, because they're afraid shitless. They are ass-lickers because they're scared to death. It's alright, I'm still. So I'm living the shithole, the hell for them every day. I don't know. Are they getting awareness or is it just for you? The awareness of being an idiot, an ass-licker, a stupid mammon, mami ferraros, to the extent of global hippopotamus. More words? Come on, I talk a lot, but I don't say bullshit. I don't say nonsense. Come on, don't size me to that. No, I can use any word. If I use sense to it. But the bullshitters, they have no sense. They are senseless shits. That's what they are. They use their senseless and stupid motherfucking assholes. But they're so scared, they even shoot their brothers and sisters. So I intend to feel empowered. I intend to, as I feel weakened. You may see me empowered. You may see me empowered, but this is not how I feel. Yeah, bits and then nothing. I work my way, like hardship after hardship after hardship. So people would start speaking up for themselves. I need strong people with strong will. With Klassenbewusstsein, who do understand what it means not to never ever go there. Yeah, the lazy fucks, they don't want to study. They still work and they, okay, I'm going to be the capital. They don't say I'm the capitalistic pig. That's going to say I'm going to kick you in the fat arse. I'm going to be the boss. That's a capitalist attitude of any Bayern. Yeah, any dumb nuts. Do you get me now? Today I was commanded to get these stuff with milk chocolate. I don't want them. I was commanded, I had to. Why? Because I have to tell you. Well, that's my whole life. I didn't get what I want. I want dark chocolate. Why do I want dark chocolate? Yeah, I can tell you because. But my entire life I didn't get what I wanted. Nothing of it. Always. And if I got a little bit, it was like milk chocolate, not dark chocolate. Well, I don't like milk chocolate as much because the reason why is there milk chocolate and not dark chocolate is because they diminish the chocolate and put more oil in it usually. More fat, that's why. So much to tell. So many things in my brain. Not good, I talk. No, I don't want to talk with my mouth full because it's not comfortable. Because I should value and cherish my food. See, Josefina, whatever, let me think all these little things about Josefina Quesada. Well, she was young too, and she wasn't really stupid, but she opted for rich instead of doing other things. So she kept the house. She could have run off with some person or not, I don't know. But she chose materialism. And then she had to adhere herself to something which she thought would be worthy to live up to or afford to or pretend to. The outfit, the style, which she kept there forever. And mannerism. Mannerism. Amanerado. Pretend I'm elegant. Yeah, stretching the finger up like that. Yeah, like the black witches in the movies who are not elegant or refined at all. She had mannerism. On her dinner table on Christmas that year. And I had elegance. And everybody noticed that. That mannerism is just not cool. And then of course I can look further if you ask me to. I look. So look at her, look at her, look at her. What does it mean, all that shit she pulled out? But she's not fuckable. Because she loses her body. She barely even, you, I can totally, I mean, I can clearly see, and that's kind of for me disgusting living in Mexico, a white skin, never seen the sun before. Yeah, like the other bitch who never wore open shoes. And that made her a better person. I go back to that one. That means that she had no good relationship with herself. That means that she had no judgment for anybody else either. That means that she hated herself. And that means that she also hated everybody else. And her friendliness wasn't friendly, it was just a smirk smile out of her face, and her mannerism, fake and unfaithful to her people. Whereas I laugh out loud like crazy, bitch. Yeah, when I laugh, I don't mind where I am. It just happened to occur that way. It's just, it comes natural, it comes, Mexicans told me, out of my belly. Well, yeah, because my laughter is honest when I laugh. And when I don't feel like laughing, I don't. I never laugh or smile when I'm not comfortable. I don't laugh at people's jokes when they're not funny. And that is what elegance also represents. Respectful. But everyone was wondering, why did Josefina downsize the diva in her house so much? Remember, I was the diva of Cuernavaca. She had no awareness because she had no clue about anything. Because she wasn't into the life of life itself. She used people. She wasn't interested in anybody. I was just a necessary evil. She only invited me because of the connection she had with whomever. Who put me there? He put me there. Yeah, the parientes. She didn't know. And then, of course, Mudelmaier died and now she needed help. I helped her getting over her asexuality. By being me, I'm not promiscuous. I'm alone. I always saw me alone. I'm lonely here, I'm lonely there, I'm lonely everywhere. But in her regard, I was from La Plebe. And I wasn't rejected by her guests, so she could go with La Plebe, Mudelmaier. Maybe that was her excuse. That must have been a thing, the people told her. The diva and the bishop. So do they have a good relationship? Huh? Yeah, well, he kissed her ass, remember? He went, and that's how people perceived it, because it was like it was. He literally bowed to the diva of Cuernavaca. He bowed to her right there in the cathedral after the very important, what amazing concert that was. So religious and so beautiful. And choirs and waterfalls and sparkling fireworks, and man, it was amazing. And I don't even know if I spoke about Diana Jimenez being mom of Salma Hayek, because I spoke about me, because remember that super dress? Oh goodness Christ, and he bowed to her. That must have been amazing, sitting with La Diva and the bishop at the same table. And what did Josefina notice? She didn't know I was the diva. She did not sing. She had no clue about anything. And particularly, she also noticed that the bishop might have bowed to me, but he had no clue what he was doing either. Because he didn't recognize me at the table. And I'm elegant, I'm fine. I don't part myself, but look at me. Applaud like Salma Hayek, look around. I don't do that shit, I'm silent. I eat my food, I'm grateful that I have food, and I listen to their dumb conversations. And how one day, in one of those events, some strange prince will appear and will actually enhance and entice my brain for once. Ciao, ciao. Arrivederci.
Don't be mad, don't get me.
Don't get mad, don't be me.
Hey, don't be mad, don't get me.
Don't get mad, don't be me.
Wait, I don't mean no harm. I can see you with my t-shirt on.
I can see you with nothing on. Feeling on me before you bring that on.
Bring that on.
You know what I mean.
Girl, I'm a freaky shit to say those things.
Only trying to get. work me the way you say.
It's okay, it's alright. I got something that you don't like.
Mm-hmm.